I woke up in a house of ghosts and ladders. It was just a two-story, ramshackle place, but held 1,000 rooms. I was in the basement before a dead furnace. I knew this was the place where children were flayed. The pantry was filled with mostly empty sealer jars, refracting light from a source I couldn't locate. One jar, on a high shelf in front of a 60-watt bulb, held a pear that glowed like a fetus. It felt like someone was in the coal bin. But when I looked, there was no one. Just a few pieces of coal. I heard faint piano music above, so I climbed a ladder to the main floor. There was flour on the linoleum and a slumping geranium on a windowsill. I walked to another room. I noticed a scurrying in each new room I entered, small wisps of dust at the doorways. The living room was empty, except for a stand-up piano. Middle C had been blackened, as if someone had put a match to it. I played a chord, but there was no sound. The wires had been cut. This was the room of endless practice, rehearsals for perfection. I heard more music, faint and above. I climbed a ladder to the second floor, ending up in the middle of a funeral. So it seemed. My head bumping against the sloped ceiling, I looked around, but there was no one. It felt like a death. A dirge from somewhere, and I spotted a plain pine coffin on two sawhorses at the gable end. I opened it slowly to a baby doll, brilliant blue eyes wide open, and fish bones all around.